Welcome to AZZ Galvanizing's facility in Joliet, Illinois. Galvanizing is a premier corrosion protection system that relies on a very thin coat of zinc to provide many decades of maintenance-free performance. Plants like this one clean steel and dip it into molten baths of zinc. Join us for a behind-the-scenes tour to see how it's done. We're arriving at the plant with a load of freshly fabricated steel. Trucks load and unload throughout the day. Forklifts transport newly arrived steel to storage areas so it can be checked in. Material check-in. During check-in, the galvanizing team inspects steel to make sure that lifting aids, venting holes, and drainage holes are all in the right place. They also look for contaminants that cannot be removed by galvanizing. If a part has an identification tag or marking, the team ensures that they'll galvanize properly while remaining legible. Staging prior to galvanizing. Moving steel parts through the galvanizing process requires a lot of coordination and dedicated equipment. During the galvanizing process, the steel is immersed in a series of process tanks containing cleaning solutions and molten zinc. Overhead cranes suspend larger parts using chain or wire. Specialized lifting devices allow plants to galvanize large numbers of similar items at the same time, while perforated baskets make it possible to galvanize smaller parts and fasteners. Surface preparation of hot dip galvanizing. It's essential that the steel be completely clean before its bath in molten zinc. A high-quality galvanized coating will only form on properly prepared surfaces, so the galvanizers dip each part into a series of pre-treatment baths first. The first pre-treatment is a degreasing bath containing a hot alkali solution, mild acidic or biological cleaning bath that removes organic contaminants such as dirt, paint, grease, and oil. From there, the steel goes into a pickling bath that contains a dilute solution of sulfuric acid or hydrochloric acid that removes mill scale and rust from the steel surface. Abrasive cleaning or air blasting sand, metallic shot, or grit onto the steel can replace or complement the pickling step. The third and final pretreatment is called fluxing. A zinc ammonium chloride solution that further cleans the steel and deposits a protective layer to prevent further oxidation prior to the immersion in the molten zinc. Hot dip galvanizing. Once the steel is fully prepared for galvanizing, it heads for a kettle of molten zinc between 820 and 850 degrees Fahrenheit. If a steel part is too big to fit into the kettle completely, galvanizers may first dip one end, then flip it around to dip the other, then coat the middle with a small overlap. Galvanizers might add other elements like aluminum, bismuth, and nickel to improve the processing or for aesthetic reasons, but the bath must contain at least 98% pure zinc by weight. This is where the magic happens. The iron in the steel reacts with the molten zinc to form a series of alloy layers that require approximately 3600 psi to remove. Galvanizing isn't a surface coating. It becomes part of the steel itself. Once the chemical process is complete, galvanizers slowly remove the steel from the bath at an angle. They use paddles to expose fresh zinc at the surface of the bath to minimize any zinc oxide deposits on the steel as it's raised. Depending on the size of the part, galvanizers may drain, vibrate, or spin the steel to remove excess zinc before cooling it in a quench tank, or simply leaving it in the open air. Inspection. Expert inspectors apply a deep understanding of galvanizing specification requirements defined in ASTM A123, A153, and A767, as well as measurement techniques to ensure that the galvanizing offers the correct level of long-term corrosion protection. Inspectors check for zinc adherence, appearance, and finish, but they're most interested in the thickness of the zinc coating. Hot-dip galvanized steel can provide decades of maintenance-free performance and the thickness of those alloy layers determine how long it can go before it is first maintained. Touch up and repair. Sometimes, small voids or defects can develop during the process or if the steel is improperly handled immediately after galvanizing. While the hot dip galvanized coating is very resistant to damage, these areas can be touched up or repaired either in the shop or in the field. According to ASTM A780, standard practice for repair of damaged and uncoated areas of hot dip galvanized coatings, these defects may be fixed with zinc-rich paint, zinc-rich solders, or thermal sprayed zinc, which is used in a slightly different process known as metallizing. Storage. The galvanized steel is ready to go, but the job site or fabrication shop may not be ready for delivery quite yet. Galvanizers stack hot dip galvanized steel at an angle with wood spacers to ensure that there's enough air flowing in and around the parts to prevent moisture buildup and help the protective zinc patina develop. If there isn't enough air flowing around the steel, it can develop a white powdery finish called wet storage stain. These wood spacers sometimes go with the steel all the way to its final destination. Forklift operators load the steel onto trucks for its journey. It's rare for pieces to be damaged during handling because the galvanized coating is so tightly bonded to the steel, but galvanizers can provide special handling when required. Hot dip galvanized steel has provided trusted, unmatched steel corrosion protection throughout the world for decades. You'll find it in almost every major application and industry where iron or mild steel is used, thanks to its durability, longevity, and low environmental impact. The next time you see a piece of galvanized steel, think of the teams at plants like this one that work tirelessly to create an iconic steel finish that stands the test of time.